everybody. So welcome to today's video, and for today we're going to be talking about truths and misconceptions about Philippine Science High School scholars, or most commonly referred to as PSHS students. Yeah. I went on and asked a bunch of people and asked them to tell me what their first impressions are, or basically just opinions in general on PSHS people. This video is where we're gonna sort out which ones are true and which ones are false.
Aww.
To do that, I gathered a bunch of my friends with me today. Like, they're my batchmates in the Philippine Science High School Central Luzon campus. And we're gonna be talking about the responses that we got from the people. And yeah, so we're basically just gonna have fun and gonna make friends together. Yeah, I'm gonna get back to you guys when they come back, and we're gonna start with the video. 3. Okay.
Wow.
Alakas.
Ang shiny ng mo.
May flag samba muna.
Prayer.
Guys, chat niyo ako, pengen jowa.
Oh, no. Online selling talaga to.
Main-main na lang
po. Ito yung pang clickbait natin na picture. No, actually, pin ko na lang kaya si Urbin. Pin ko nga na yung manood.
Pin ko na kikita si Urbin.
Okay. So, di ba nag-ano tayo? Like, gumawa tayo ng link na makakapagsabi sila ng mga impressions nila and opinions on PSHS students, kanyan. So, una-una. Yeah. Una-una.
Hello.
Is it true na PSHS students or nerds na almost lahat ng time nila is pinispend ng studying lang?
De-
no. Hindi ko na rinig. What?
Sana.
Sino gusto magsalita?
Alam, nag-freeze.
Yung mag-
True!
Okay. Lois.
Where... nerdy in a way na we study more than people in other schools kasi mas mahirap yung lessons natin and mas marami yung academic pressure, if that makes sense. Hindi naman tayo nerds in a way na wala tayong social life kasi yun yung misconception ng maraming tao.
Yeah, that's so true. You know what? Honestly, yun yung second na ano, second stereotype na ibibring up ko sana. The second one is ano, yun nga, like Lois said na people are asking kung totoo bang boring yung mga PSHS students ganun, tapos hindi tayo marunong
mag-sa- No?
No? What?
No.
Like, di ba, most of the week nasa PSHS tayo. So like, from Monday to Friday tayo rin magkakasama. So like, pag weekend, parang hirap din makipag-socialize with other friends sa other schools.
Kung titingnan, parang yung mga campuses din talaga ng PSHS, parang malayo din talaga sila sa most schools within the cities or kung saan man.
Dahil sa stereotype na yon, wala nang gaano nagiging friends siguro yung PSHS people outside of PSHS community. Know what I'm saying?
Personally, feel ko people forget na we're high schoolers din. Kasi when you're in PSHS, they think na, wow, ang taas ng intellect nila, they must be different level, you know? Pero we're the same as other high schoolers who just want to have fun and be with friends most of the time.
Yeah.
I commend your answer. Yes.
I think that's enough for yung second na stereotype. So let's move on to the third one. So hey, someone said na tingin niya raw sa PSHS toxic and very competitive yung culture. Is that true?
I don't think so.
Ganon.
So, maybe it's because like hindi nire-rank yung BLs natin. So, hindi tayo nagiging competitive. Like, we're all just helping each other. It's just very supportive.
Mostly, it's a conversation of yourself. Diba, minsan mga ibang tao nga, natulungan tayo, uy, 1.5, uy, BL ka na, diba? Mas masaya tayo na mas maraming tao makakarigin ng goal natin.
Mas feel ko, yes.
Okay, Ajo.
To us, it's just na parang it's just a normal day. Pero if you look outside, it looks like we're competing with each other now. how we're saying na, ah, I got a higher score than you. Oh, mababa ka pala. Mm. Mga ganon.
But then again, I think, na, like, just with any other high school, like, parang, there's always gonna be some people na ganon talaga, na gusto ka unang
yeah.
and ganon. Pero not really, like, lahat, not general.
Correct. It depends the circle mo of friends. If you surround yourself with non-toxic people.
Dahil na rin maraming mga requirements sa PSI, iniisip ng ibang tao, like, ay, baka hindi na sila natutulog, baka toxic sa kanila. Pero hindi nila alam yung parang reality na inaangat natin lahat sa para maging DL lahat.
Totoo yun, na parang, ewan ko, sa PSI, parang, sa PSI ako nakahanap ng super strong na friendships talaga. Okay. We're done with three stereotypes. So, for now, I think we're gonna move to the fourth one. Ayun, merong nagsabi sa responses na sa tingin niya raw, besides students, mabilis daw tayong ma-burn out emotionally. Is that true or not?
Give us time to think. Depende sa tao yun, di ba?
Depende.
From elementary to high school, iba yung environment natin. Mafe-feel mo yung pressure na, ah, nasa Pisay ako, dapat galingan ko. For example, so, nung grade 7, bumagsak ka for the first time. Siyempre, maapektuhan ka na sobrang-sobra. Pero matutulungan ka naman ng friends mo if ever na-feel mo gano'n.
It's always the friends, like, sobrang vital nila sa buong Pisay life mo.
Yeah. I feel like kaya siya na-generalize kasi parang natitrain tayo na pag maraming binibigay sa atin, tinatanggap lang natin. Emotionally, nagpa-pile up siya until minsan sumasabog na lang tayo tapos nag-rage tayo sa Twitter kasi di na natin kaya.
Pero kakayanin din naman.
And I think it's a good, preparation for college, I guess.
Ito, speaking from my experience, no? Feeling ko, compared to others, mas marami akong stuff. Pero hindi ako yung person na madaling ma-burn out.
I think, if I'm not mistaken, Josh, like, parang lagi kang nasa upper 5 ng batch, gano'n, like, basically, wow. Competition, ganyan, kasama siya, meron din siyang Sayurani concert, dance concert, kasama siya.
Ay!
Like, kasi, totoo.
Multi-talented.
Sobra.
Different person, different coping mechanism naman kasi.
Pero yeah, but then again, like, we're not, it's true naman, and we're not gonna deny it na a lot of people in our institution actually, like, suffer from mental health issues, ganyan. But yeah, I guess with every high school naman, not just Pisay, like, we experience that kind of things. Mm. Yeah, we should we move on na sa next one. So, sabi ng mga tao, Pisay students raw, hindi gaanong mahilig or hindi gaanong magaling sa sports or kaya sa art.
I'm offended!
Athletes, artists!
I nominate Leander.
Rising star!
Rising star.
To be honest, marami pa rin naman tayong mga free time. Like, pag lumabas ka during ISD, may mga nagpa-volleyball side, may mga nagpa-basketball support. Hindi pa rin nawawala, in my opinion, yung time natin for recreational and sports.
Honestly, me, I came from a football background, and going into Pisay, I still have that football background, and I'm still athletic in that way.
Kasi it depends sa priorities ng person.
Jessa, kaya ba?
Jessa, buhay ka pa? Yeah. Hindi ka na MP4 JPEG ka na.
Finals week na, or quarter exam, like, may tournament pa rin ako before nun, the weekend before nun. So, kung passionate ka, edi, you pursue mo. But
some athletes kasi, student athletes outside of Pisay, parang tutok na tutok talaga sila sa training na ayun. Pero sa Pisay kasi, maraming ang club activities and the like. Pero hindi lang tayo ganun ka 100% na doon. Like, parang sinasali lang natin siya sa routine natin para, ayun nga, holistic development.
What's holistic development?
Pero nabasa ko lang kanina eh.
Word of the day.
Parang sounds right.
Ito more on sa arts siya. Every grade level talaga, meron siyang parang, yung sa art, grade 7 and 8, parang may open house, so ide-design niyo yung classrooms niyo, ganon. Sa mga play, ganon, like, papanoorin talaga ng buong school. Nang galing ako sa school na nagpo-poster ako, cartooning, ganon.
Tapos feel ko naman, hindi siya nawala nung nag-Pisay ako. Tapos mas marami pa ako nakilalang mga artist friends na magaling talaga dun sa ginagawa nila.
Wala naman nagpipigil sa amin. It's really the passion na nagpo-push sa amin if gusto talaga namin mag-engage into sports or sa arts.
Sobrang true. I think Pisay gives us opportunities naman talaga to like grow in other aspects and not just academically. It just so happens that we're more known for that kind of thing. So, moving on. Ito medyo ano, medyo hot take. Like,
spicy.
Sabi niya, besides students are elitist and they look down on content people. And so basically we have this like superiority complex like with people outside of Pisay or outside of
STEM. Yan.
When I interact with other people, hindi ko naman iniisip na, oh, taga-Pisay ako, sila hindi. Lahat naman tayo may different strengths. And baka iba lang yung sa Pisay, tapos yung other schools, diba?
I feel ko, it's the opposite. Because people think we have a superiority complex, they want to bring us down. In the Philippines, we have more of a intellectual shaming problem going on.
Yes.
Like, ako, when people say na, uy, taga-Pisay ka, you must be smart. Eh, ano to? Ano yan? Ay, hindi ka pala smart. Ang ganun.
Yung one of the evidences na hindi talaga elitist yung mga Pisay is yung dami ng humanitarian activities na na-initiate ng mga Pisay scholars. Ang daming tumutulong sa mga IPs, sa mga public school na children na bata, yung mga far-flung areas. Yung sa Arangkada para sa mga jeepney drivers at Haki 19. So, I think yun yung mga proof na hindi talaga elitist yung mga Pisay. Kasi we're into serving the people. We're into serving back the community talaga.
Isa sa mga main things na natutunan ko is sa Pisay is to like really love my country and the community where I'm in. And like, parang I learned na it's so important to be part of something bigger than yourself. Lalo na with the fact na scholar tayo ng bayan, like, it's a privilege for us to have that responsibility na mag-serve sa people.
It's part of our ano yung core values, yung service. Yeah, service to the people. So, that lessens the chance of us looking down on these so-called people.
Ito medyo ano lang, I guess hindi naman siya major thing. May nagsabi sa akin nito na higher year si Happy Kristen. No. Yung scholar ng bayan, tsaka scholar para sa bayan. Ang sabi is like, it's better to call ourselves scholar ng bayan. Kasi parang, you put yourself in a position na you're parang standing alongside yung people, na, which is yung bayan. And you're not just like, parang, you're not up there giving back to sa mga nasa baba. But the thing is, you're all on the same ground and you're standing with
yeah.
them. Ayan! Wow. So,
support.
Fruitful
discussion. Wow! Stay here.
Okay, so last. Ito yung pinaka widespread, I guess, the stereotype sa Pisay students. Mm-hmm. Which is, Pisay students, sila yung cream of the crop.
Nah.
Before ka makapasok ng Pisay, kailangan mong magpass yung NCA. Sobrang limited lang kasi ng mga passers doon. So parang kapag napass mo yun, sasabihin nila na sobrang talino mo, gano'n. Pag pumasok ka naman sa Pisay, parang normal student.
In an outside point of view, they think we're the cream of the crop because all of us passed the NCE. But I also don't agree na we're the cream of the crop because not everybody took the NCE. Kasi I know a lot of people sa probinsya ko na who don't even know that exists.
True.
Marami ring hindi nag-a-accept kahit nakapasa sila sa NCE. Hindi lahat ng magagaling nandun na automatically sa Pisay, hindi siya.
Kasi parang for us, like, lalo na we're there nearly every day, parang normal thing na lang sa atin. But we have to consider na sa outsider's perspective, when you get yung top ng bawat school, talagang naturally isipin nila na cream of the crop talaga tayo.
Yeah. Not to be paham, like, I mean, syempre, as much as possible, like, we humble ourselves. Pero parang, medyo we're really gifted din naman talaga in a way. And yeah. I mean, Pisay really gives us really good education din talaga.
I think nagdi-differ lang siya sa mga ano, sa mga truly passionate about math and science na meron din sa other schools.
Wait, guys, post tayo last before we end this.
Erwin, you're the crazy that people see in this,
eh? Albert Einstein. One, Ganyan. Two, three. I hope that was helpful, and I hope that you'll be able to use that brand new knowledge in the future. For example, if you want to study in Pisay, I hope that gave you a clear idea of what our culture in our school actually is. Yeah? I also just want to put it out there that my friends and I don't represent the entire student population of Philippine Science High School. Because first of all, it's just my friends and I. The things said in this video are solely just my opinions and my friends' opinions, and they would probably differ from the opinions of other Pisay students, especially like there are like more than like 16 campuses in the whole country, and we're all just from Central Luzon campus. The environment at each campus might differ as well. But yeah, overall, I hope that you liked this video and I hope that you enjoyed the discussion as much as we did. Stay tuned for more videos and more discussions like this. And yeah, don't forget to click like, subscribe, and leave a comment down below. Like, tell us what you think about the video, or just your thoughts. We want to talk to you, so bye!